because I didn't have my run. But I can dig deep down and get one more out of the tank if I wanted to, and if the right opportunity, I'll do it.
We put you in the ring with Manny Pacquiao. What would happen?
Manny Pacquiao and Bernard Hopkins, boxing. And I also hit him on the hip, missed his leg up. And it'd be an exciting fight. Pacquiao's a type of fighter with my style. I'll just grind him down later on in the fight and get him out of there. But it will be a competitive fight.
How about Floyd?
Floyd would be the easier fight for me. It'd be one of the most easiest fights that I fight in my whole career. Why? Because he's a counterpuncher. And he normally waits till you commit yourself, and then he capitalizes, which is a good strategy. But if you're fighting a guy like with my all-around skills, I can beat you backwards, I can beat you sideways, I can beat you coming forward, I can beat you in an old Philadelphia drag-out alley type of fight. So Floyd will be a fight for me where it won't be as difficult as the fighters that's fighting him right now.
Let me ask you this. In your opinion, who's the best pound-for-pound fighter today? Is there one?
Right now? Pacquiao.
Hands down. Now, we're here today for Israel's last.
That's only by Floyd's admission and Floyd's fault. Floyd Mayweather left boxing, adds pound for pound, and 19 months went by, boxing waits for nobody. Not even the great Muhammad Ali, Joe Louis, or Ray Robinson when they was here. When Ali was sat down for 2 years or 3 years of his boxing career for not going to the draft or not being drafted, boxing still continued to make heavyweight fights. When he defaulted and left, I mean, Pacquiao earned some good victories and cemented his spot at number one. And right now, he's number one.
Now, I got to ask you this. Your life story, from where all your ups and downs, you're now almost like CEO of a major company. And where you ever sit back and reflect, like, what happened? Like, how did my life turn out like this?
If you do that, it's like somebody chasing you down the street. Once you run and look back, they're going to catch you. Look back slows you down. I think that what keeps me going is to look forward, knowing that there's so much stuff to do, whether it's boxing related or whether it's business related, which I like to do. I mean, you might not notice it. I can be an argument. I like to debate. I like to dispute a lot of things. I like to figure out things. I am about detail. So I think that any business that I choose to do will be like a fine pair of shoes that fits perfectly, like a, you know, your hand snugged in a glove. It's just something that I've got accustomed to, and I like doing it.
You ever thought of being an attorney?
No, because I got 9 felonies, and I don't think you can have felonies and be an attorney. I can tell you this. I can tell you this. Being around lawyers, being around business people, I think my most positive is that I had a lot of teaching without being taught by the particular person, by being in certain environments, by being in certain circles of lawyers and business people, I paid attention to how to talk. I paid attention to how to think, how to talk, how to carry myself, how to present myself, because I know what people might think of me because I'm just, you know, I'm under the banner of a fighter. And unfortunately, there's not a lot of great representation from the past and the future of what I do, boxing. So I'm constantly under a microscope. For those who don't know about boxing, one thing they do know, brain damage. And so the average person that know that you take punches for a living might not know that I ducked 90% of mine. Might not know that I got one of the most greatest defense in the last 20, 30 years of any boxer that put gloves on. Let alone I've never been cut or knocked out or beat up in 60-plus fights over 22 years of boxing. They don't know all all this information. They just know that I just happen to be there. This is non-boxing people. They don't know I managed and promoted myself for 90% of my career because I didn't want to get screwed by some promoters and I didn't want to get taken advantage of. Now, isn't it ironic that even in my personal career of boxing, I was forced and wasn't lazy enough to be my own man and willing to sacrifice not getting to where I've gotten based on learning business about boxing and fighting at the same time. Who would have thought that me and Oscar De La Hoya would fight? 6 months later, we become partners, and to my eyes, the most powerful, if not now, definitely tomorrow, boxing company in boxing right now. Just by the time that's on our side. The time is not on Bob Arum's side, Don King. The time is on our side because no other boxing promoter company has the prestige of having Oscar Bernard Hopkins and Sugar Shane Mosley, one ballot Hall of Famers, without even a vote. That helps and gives the company so much credibility for the fighters that's looking to find a home. Who you think they really want to be with? It ain't got to do with who's going to take care of them, who's going to be fair, who's not going to be fair. But they know that we can relate to missing Christmas because we in camp. Thanksgiving because we in camp. Not seeing the newborn or the unborn. They understand that we understand why. Because we are them. Just with business suits on. That credibility can't be mocked, can't be altered. It can't be, you know, credibility is what it is. You can't buy credibility. You can front your way and fraud your way, do anything else. But one thing about credibility, it has to be earned. It has to be. Because people got computers. They can call. They got cell phones. They can find out who the fuck you, excuse me, who you really are. I went ghetto a little bit, but that's good. They can find out who the F you are within seconds today, thanks to technology.
Are you on Twitter?
No. I haven't learned. I just learned how to text. I'm just starting to text. My daughter teased me. She said I want to text. Seriously, I'm not embarrassed to say that. I'm old school, y'all. I'm 44 years old, and I must admit, wherever this going at, YouTube or whatever, I just started texting about 3 months ago. Now, and I must say now that I should, a year ago, maybe 2 years ago, because a lot of people I don't want to talk to, and you just want to text. So right now, I'm late, but better late than never, right?
Yeah.
Bernard, right on Twitter.
Bernard, in the past you talked about moving up to heavyweight. Coming up this week, you got Areola fighting. He's not the biggest heavyweight. He's a big guy, but not that big. Is that something you'd be?
No, because back then I was a little younger, right? I was taking heavyweight. Now as I'm 44, fast approaching 45, 5 months, 4 months, whatever my math is right, January 15th, 1965, the heavyweight is out of the equation. Right now, I think that if I fight again, which is a